Today we are going to study Chapter 8 of NCERT Class 5 EVS, A Treat for Mosquitoes. First of all, you should understand what does it mean when we say a treat for mosquitoes. A treat means a special food or drink that causes special pleasure or delight. And what will be that special drink for mosquitoes? It is our blood. And if we give a treat to the mosquitoes, we are definitely going to suffer. In this chapter, we are going to learn about mosquito spread diseases and in detail about malaria, its symptoms, diagnosis, treatment and prevention. Then about nutrients of food with special reference to minerals, about anemia, its symptoms, diagnosis, treatment and prevention. Reading a pathology report, to know and appreciate the contribution of the scientists, with special reference to Ronald Ross. Then about flies spread diseases, about algae and water weeds, other things in water, cleanliness important for health, and a project work, make a poster to create awareness about malaria. So let's start our chapter, A Treat for Mosquitoes. Blood test. Rajat is back at school today. He had been absent for many days. How are you now? Asked Aarti. I'm all right, Rajat replied softly. Jaskirat said, you must have prayed a lot while you were at home. Rajat, who wants to play when you have fever? On top of it, I had to take a bitter medicine. I even had a blood test. Jaskirat, a blood test? Why? It must have been very painful. Rajat, actually, when the needle pricked my finger, it felt like an ant bite. They took 2 to 3 drops of blood and sent it for testing. That's how we came to know that I had malaria. Nancy, but you get malaria when a mosquito bites you. Rajat, yes, but we find out by the blood test. Jaskirat, there are a lot of mosquitoes in my house these days, but I did not get malaria. Nancy, who says that every mosquito bite causes malaria? Malaria spreads only by the disease-carrying mosquitoes. Aarti, all mosquitoes look the same to me. Rajat, there must be some difference. So this was the conversation going on among the children. There are a lot of mosquitoes in my house too. Mosquitoes are always annoying and irritating. Let it be the disturbing buzzes or the bites. The swelling after it bites is another bothersome and itchy one. I bet the itching just makes things worse.
Mujhe neend na aaye, neend na aaye, neend na aaye. Kat ke bhag jaye, kat ke bhag jaye. Mujhe neend na aaye, kat ke bhag jaye. Khujlate hum reh jaye. Dadoda machhar de gaya, badan mein khujale de gaya. Dadoda machhar de gaya, badan mein khujale de gaya. Kaano mein bhin bhin ka shor machate hain. Kat kat ke sabki neend bhagate. कछुआ छाप मोर्टीन भी इनके आगे फेल हुआ मारने जाए तब तक उड़ जाए खुजलाते हम रह जाए ददोड़ा मच्छर दे गया बदन में खुजाले दे गया.
Rajat had been absent for many days. He had fever. He had to take a bitter medicine. He even had a blood test and came to know that he had malaria. We have fever in many diseases. Let us try to know some more details about fever in malaria. That is, the symptoms of malaria. When a person suffers from malaria, he will have chills and rigors. Chills means cold and rigors means shivering. Then he'll have high fever, headache, nausea means feeling to vomit, vomiting and diarrhea. Muscle pain also, weakness and sweats profusely. The cycle of fever goes like this. It starts with a feeling of cold and shivering, which lasts for 15 to 60 minutes. Then high fever from 102 degree Fahrenheit to 105 degree Fahrenheit, lasting 2 to 6 hours, accompanied by headache, nausea, vomiting and diarrhea, muscle pain, weakness, and at the end, the fever drops rapidly. The patient sweats profusely over a period of 2 to 4 hours. Fever and sweating last 4 to 6 hours. Fever occurs every 2 to 3 days. When Rajat had fever, he went to a doctor. As I told you that we have fever in many diseases, so to find out the actual cause of fever, doctor suggested a blood test. For blood test, a needle is pricked in finger. It feels like an ant bite. They take 2 to 3 drops of blood on a glass slide and send it for testing in lab. The doctor observes it under a microscope. This is a microscope. In this picture, Dr. Mariam is looking at the blood slide under the microscope. This microscope makes things look 1000 times bigger. The details inside the blood can be seen clearly. There are some microscopes which make things look even more bigger than this one. A microscope is an instrument used to see magnified images of two small objects which cannot be seen through naked eyes. That's how he came to know that he had malaria. Nancy asked, "But how could they find out that you had malaria by your blood test? Do you think they could see something in the blood?" "Yes, they could see the germs of malaria in blood sample. This is the blood sample which was collected on a glass slide. On observing under a microscope, they could see these germs which are of malaria. And this is the pathological report of his blood test. Look at the report of the blood test given here. Which words in the report help us to know that the person has malaria? Let us first read the report. Name Rajat, age 11 years, sex male, diagnosis fever with chills and rigors. It is clearly mentioned in the report that malarial parasite has been found in the blood sample. Rajat was diagnosed with malaria. Now let us find out that from where did the malaria germs come into his blood. Here is the conversation of the children. Nancy, but you get malaria when a mosquito bites you? Rajat, yes, we find out by the blood test. Jaskirat, there are a lot of mosquitoes in my house these days, but I did not get malaria. Nancy, who says that every mosquito bite causes malaria? Malaria spreads only by the disease-carrying mosquitoes. Aarti, all mosquitoes look the same to me. Rajat, there must be some difference. Yes, there are differences. Though all mosquitoes look the same to us, but all are different. Here are some common mosquitoes. Female Anopheles mosquito, female Aedes mosquito, and female Culex mosquito. Now you may have a question that why all female mosquitoes? This is because males do not feed on blood. Only female mosquitoes feed on blood. Male mosquitoes only eat flower nectar. Female mosquitoes eat both flower nectar and blood. A male mosquito's antenna is much bushy. A female mosquito's antennae are less bushy. Let's find, do all mosquitoes spread malaria? Only female Anopheles mosquitoes carrying germs spread malaria. When a female Anopheles mosquito bites a malaria patient, it takes the blood with germs of malaria and becomes infected. When this infected female Anopheles mosquito carrying germs bites a healthy person, the germs are injected and released into the blood of the healthy person, and the healthy person gets malaria. When the blood test confirms that a person is suffering from malaria, then he is given medicine for malaria. From early times, the dried and powdered bark of the cinchona tree was used to make a medicine for malaria. Earlier, people used to boil the bark powder and strain the water which was given to patients. Now, tablets are made from this. This is cinchona tree, bark of cinchona tree, and this is bark dried. And these are the tablets. Prevention is better than cure. Prevention means to avoid and cure means to correct anything that is troublesome. It is sensible to stop an illness from happening in the first place than to have to deal with problems and worse health issues. While we can't completely avoid mosquito bites, some simple lifestyle changes can protect us from getting bitten by these insects. How can we protect ourselves from mosquitoes? How can we stop or prevent malaria? To understand the preventive measures, we have to first understand the life cycle of mosquitoes. The mosquito goes through four stages of life cycle: egg, larva, pupa, and adult. Mosquitoes lay their eggs on the surface of fresh or stagnant water or on damp soil. The water may be in tin cans, barrels, ponds, swimming pools, puddles, ditches, or marshy areas. A female mosquito may lay a raft of eggs, means the eggs are stuck together. They float on the surface of the water. Next stage is larva. The larva, plural larvae, lives in the water and comes to the surface to breathe and hang upside down from the water surface. Anopheles larvae lie parallel to water surface to get a supply of oxygen. Baby mosquitoes are called larvae. The larva changes into a pupa. They flip off their tails towards the bottom or protective areas. This is the time the mosquito changes into an adult. The adult mosquito emerges. The newly emerged adult rests on the surface of water for a short time to allow itself to dry. The wings have to spread out and dry properly before it can fly. So, the mosquito goes through four stages of its life cycle: egg, larva, pupa, and adult. So, the first preventive measure is to identify the breeding places of mosquitoes, that is, the places suitable for the growth and development of mosquitoes. Mosquitoes breed and lay their eggs in or near water bodies. Any place that collects any form of stagnant water, means water not flowing, it's standing, are breeding places for mosquitoes. So larvae of Anopheles mosquitoes, that is the baby mosquitoes, are found in a lot of places where rainwater is collected or is stored, such as swamps, pits, tanks, pots, buckets, plant pots, discarded bottles, open tins or cans, lorry tire, rice fields, grass ditches, shallow pools, low-lying areas, edges of streams and ponds, pools at construction sites, irrigated lands, broken water pipes, poorly maintained drains, etc. Once the breeding places are identified, prevent breeding. That is, prevent waterlogging or stagnation. Don't let water collect around your house. Fill up the pits. Removing standing water is a useful first step in reducing mosquito populations. Water is logged in pits on the roads, puddles, grassy dishes, around hand pump, and also uneven surfaces in your surroundings, which acts as a breeding place for mosquitoes. Mosquitoes usually breed in the excess water in potted plants or empty flower pots filled with water. So make sure you do not overwater these plants. Keep the water pots, coolers, and tanks clean. They should be dried every week. That is why Nancy says, there was an old pot lying behind our house. It was full of water for some days. When I looked there, I saw some tiny thread-like grey things swimming. I was surprised when Mummy told me that these had come out of the eggs which mosquitoes lay in water. They are called larvae. I also heard something about this on the radio. Rajat, what did you do? Nancy, Papa immediately threw away the water. He cleaned and dried the pot and kept it upside down so that no water would collect. Uncovered water tanks. Mosquitoes breed in such stagnant water. Cover them. Open drainage system. If you live in an area where there is an open drainage system, your risk of suffering from malaria is very high. As mosquitoes breed in such unhygienic places, you should report to concerned officials. Stagnant water in tires are breeding place for mosquitoes. Dustbin or trash can. Do you cover your dustbin when not in use? Well, uncovered dustbins attract mosquitoes and allow them to multiply. Throw your trash every day and clean the bin once a week. Keep your surroundings clean or it will allow the mosquitoes to breed. These are some more breeding sites of mosquitoes: drum, buckets, cans, pots, hand pump, tires, and so many unused items. Even few drops of water in the bucket or a bucket filled with water that has not been used for many days can cause the mosquitoes to breed. So if you are going anywhere, either cover it or empty the bucket. So the first step was to identify the breeding places and prevent water logging. But water logging cannot always be checked at all places. So the next step is, if there is water logging, kill larvae, that is the baby mosquitoes, by spraying oil or chemical insecticides. Like in these pictures, you can see spraying oil and chemical in the rice fields, drains, grassy ditches, accumulated water and flooded water. Now there is a question, what will happen when oil is spread on the water? As I have shown you, most larvae hang on the water surface in order to breathe. When oil is spread on the water surface, a barrier is formed between the larvae and the air, cutting off oxygen and suffocating the larvae and pupae. This kills the mosquitoes in their larval stage before they develop into adult mosquitoes. And secondly, the oil film will prevent any mosquito from laying eggs as long as the oil film covers the entire surface of the water. There is one more way to kill larvae. Mosquito fish in pools and ponds. Fish eats mosquito larvae and pupae and kills mosquitoes in their larval stage before they develop into adult mosquitoes. To kill adult mosquitoes, fogging or fumigation or outdoor spray may be done. Fogging is a technique used for killing insects in which chemical is sprayed producing thick fog. Indoor spray of insecticides is also done to kill adult mosquitoes. Next step is to prevent entry of mosquitoes. Mosquitoes can enter your house through windows and doors, and the only way to prevent their entry is to cover your windows and doors with nets, that is mosquito netting. Mosquito mesh on windows and doors allow air and light to enter the house but prevent the mosquito from entering. After taking so many measures, mosquitoes are still there. So now prevent biting by using mosquito nets, long trousers, long-sleeved shirts. Lighter colors generally attract fewer insects than darker colors. Then by using mosquito repellents such as fabric roll-on, repellent spray, cream, coil, liquid vaporizers, perfumed sticks. Plants with a strong aroma that produce a fragrance are something mosquitoes don't like. So grow rosemary, marigold, mint or lemongrass around your home to keep mosquitoes away. Do you know anyone who has had malaria? Yes, one of my friends had malaria. How did they find out that they had malaria? It was found by the blood test. What problems did they have on having malaria? Feeling of cold and shivering lasting for 15 to 60 minutes. High fever from 102 degree Fahrenheit to 105 degree Fahrenheit lasting for 2 to 6 hours. Headache, nausea, vomiting and diarrhea. Muscle pain, weakness and at the end the fever drops rapidly. The patient sweats profusely over a period of 2 to 4 hours. Fever and sweating lasting 4 to 6 hours. Fever occurs every 2 to 3 days. What other diseases can be caused by mosquito bites? Other diseases caused by mosquito bites are chikungunya, dengue, filaria, encephalitis. Chikungunya and dengue is transmitted to humans by the bites of infected female Aedes mosquitoes. They mainly bite during the day. Along with other symptoms, skin rashes appear. Filaria may be spread by female Anopheles, Aedes and Culex mosquitoes. Your arms and legs can swell and become much bigger than they should be. The affected skin can thicken and harden to look something like an elephant's skin. That is why it is also called elephantiasis. Female Culex mosquito spreads encephalitis. Encephalitis can damage the brain and cause memory problems, speech and language problems. In which season is malaria more common? Why do you think this happens? Malaria is more common in rainy season. Due to waterlogging in rainy season, mosquitoes get suitable environment to breed. What do you do in your house to protect yourself from mosquitoes? Don't let water collect around your house. Fill up the pits. Keep the water pots, coolers and tanks clean and dry every week. Cover water tanks. Throw trash every day and clean the bin once a week. Keep your surroundings clean. Close doors, windows and cover with nets. Use mosquito net. Cover yourself. Full sleeves and legs covering clothes. Use mosquito repellents. Open unhygienic drains. Report to concerned officials. Spray oil or chemical insecticides and report to concerned officials. Mosquito fish in pools and ponds. A scientist peeps into a mosquito's stomach. This interesting incident took place almost 100 years ago. A scientist found out that mosquitoes spread malaria. Let's read about this discovery in his own words. In those days, thousands of people used to die from a disease that we now call malaria. The disease was found in areas where there was a lot of rain or in swampy places. People thought that the illness was caused by some poisonous gas that came from the dirty, swampy areas. They gave it the name malaria, which means bad air. Ronald Ross chased a lot of mosquitoes, did a lot of experiments and found out that malaria is caused only by female Anopheles mosquito. In December 1902, Ronald Ross got the highest award for his discovery, the Nobel Prize for Medicine. There is a poster on malaria to create awareness about mosquitoes and prevention. Some of the important points given in the poster are you inviting mosquitoes? Beware! They spread malaria, dengue, chikungunya. Don't let water collect around your house. Fill up the pits. Keep the water pots, coolers and tanks clean. They should be dried every week. Use mosquito nets to protect yourself. Spray kerosene if water has collected at some place. Why do you think pictures of tanks, cooler and pits are shown in the poster? Because these are the stuff where breeding of mosquitoes can take place if they are waterlogged or are not cleaned up regularly. So now, make a poster with a message to keep the cooler, tank, drains and the area clean wherever water collects. Put up your poster in and around your school. There is a project work for you. Make a poster to create awareness about malaria. We have learned that mosquitoes spread diseases like malaria, dengue, chikungunya, filaria, encephalitis, etc. Diseases that are spread from one person to the other are called communicable diseases. These diseases are catchy or infectious and are caused by germs. Here are some more examples of communicable diseases: measles, chickenpox, mumps, flu, tuberculosis, COVID-19, typhoid, cholera. All these diseases are highly contagious, that is spread from one person to another. Jaskirat says, Shazia aunty told me that even flies spread diseases, especially stomach problems. Rajat, but flies don't bite, then how do they spread diseases? Flies sit on dirty things and germs stick to their hair and legs. When they sit on our food, the germs are transferred to our food items. If a healthy person eats such food, germs enter his body and the person may fall ill. Which diseases are spread by flies and how? The most common diseases are dysentery, diarrhea, typhoid, cholera, gastroenteritis, tuberculosis. Here are the glimpses of house flies sitting on human and animal shit, garbage and other dirty things. After seeing this, you must realize that how dirty and dangerous these flies are. That is why it is advised not to eat uncovered fruits or food items and open street food. After sitting on such dirty things, they deposit the germs on cut, uncovered fruits or food items and open street food. If a healthy person eats such food, germs enter his body and the person may fall ill. Now we shall learn about a new disease called anemia. When Rajat told about him suffering from malaria and the blood test, Aarti says, you know, I also had to get a blood test done. But they took a syringe full of blood. The blood test showed that I had anemia. Rajat, what is that? Aarti, the doctor said that there is less hemoglobin or iron in the blood. The doctor gave some medicines to give me strength. He also said that I should eat jaggery, amla and more green leafy vegetables because they have iron. Nancy, how can there be iron in your blood? Jaskirat, there was something about this in the newspaper yesterday. Rajat, laughing, so then you ate iron or what? Aarti, silly, this is not the iron used to make these keys. I don't know exactly what it was, but after I ate a lot of vegetables and whatever the doctor had said, my hemoglobin went up. Aarti says, I don't know exactly what it was. I will tell you what it was. In chapter 3, from tasting to digesting, you have learnt about nutrients of food. Let us quickly revise. Our body needs nutrients for good health, energy, repair and growth. There are 6 major nutrients: carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Carbohydrates are energy-giving food. They give us energy to work and play. We get carbohydrates from sugar, rice, glucose, potato, wheat, honey, etc. Fats also give energy to the body. They give more energy than carbohydrates. This energy can be stored in the body. In addition, they give heat and warmth to the body. We get fats from foods like oil, butter, ghee, nuts and red meat. Proteins are called body-building food. They help in growth and development of the body. They help to repair the damaged cells and build new cells. They are mainly found in food like pulses, eggs, meat, cheese, milk and soya bean, fish, etc. Growing children need more proteins in their diet. Vitamins and minerals are known as protective food as they help to fight diseases and infections. They are found in green leafy vegetables, fruits, milk and eggs. Minerals are needed in very small quantity but are needed for our proper health. The main minerals needed in our diet are iron, iodine, calcium, magnesium, potassium and zinc. If these minerals are not sufficient in our diet, then it is called mineral deficiency. So it was this iron Aarti was talking about. Nancy said, how can there be iron in your blood? Rajat was laughing. So you ate iron or what? Aarti, silly, this is not the iron used to make these keys. I don't know exactly what it was. So, this iron is a mineral found in plants and animals. It is an important component of hemoglobin. And what is hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is the red color of your blood. Anemia is a decrease in hemoglobin in the blood. Anemia is caused by a shortage of iron in your body. For proper growth and development, we need iron from diet. Your body regularly gets iron from the foods you eat. If you consume too little iron, over time your body can become iron deficient. Look at this picture. This is the blood of a normal person and this is of an anemic person. Anemia common in Delhi school. 17th November 2007. Thousands of children studying in the municipal corporation schools in Delhi suffer from anemia. This is affecting both their physical as well as mental health. Due to anemia, children do not grow well and their energy levels are low. This also affects their ability to study properly. Now health checkups are being done in the schools and health cards are being made for all the children. Anemic children are also being given iron tablets. How do we know that we are suffering from anemia? What are the symptoms of anemia? The symptoms of anemia are pale skin. Normally our skin looks pinkish or reddish. Pale skin means it looks dull, yellowish. Pale eyes, feel tired, feel weak, headache, cold hands and feet, brittle nails and poor physical and mental growth. When Aarti was unwell, she also had to get a blood test done. But they took a syringe full of blood. Do you remember Rajat suffered from malaria and only 2 to 3 drops of blood was taken on a glass slide for test? But they took a syringe full of blood to test anemia. The blood test showed that she had anemia. This is her clinical pathology report. Let us now read this report. Clinical pathology report, Central Government Health Scheme. Date 20th June 2007. Name Aarti. Age 12. Sex female. Diagnosis anemia. Hemoglobin 8 grams per deciliter. Normal range 12 to 16 grams per deciliter. This shows that hemoglobin level in her blood is quite less and this condition is called anemia. The doctor gave some medicines to give strength. He also said that she should eat jaggery, amla and more green leafy vegetables because these have iron. Even mulberry, pomegranate, peas, red guava, apple, beans, eggs, chicken, banana, raisin, honey are rich in iron. These are some more iron-rich food items to increase hemoglobin of blood. Aarti's blood test was done on 20th June 2007 after taking medicines and iron-rich food. Her blood was tested again after 3 months on 15th September 2007. Look at Aarti's blood report and find out the minimum required hemoglobin. Minimum required hemoglobin in blood should be 12 grams per deciliter. How much did Aarti's hemoglobin go up and how long did it take for that? Hemoglobin went up from 8 grams per deciliter to 10.5 grams per deciliter in 3 months. What does the newspaper report say about the problems caused by anemia? Anemia affects both physical and mental health. Children do not grow well, have less energy and are not able to study properly. What was found out by the blood test? Aarti suffered from anemia. You have learnt about communicable diseases. Now the diseases that occur due to lack or deficiency of nutrients over a long period are called deficiency diseases. In chapter 3, From Tasting to Digesting, there was a question that what would happen if a child does not get enough roti or rice to eat? It was protein calorie malnutrition. Some more deficiency diseases are rickets due to calcium deficiency, goiter due to iodine deficiency, scurvy due to vitamin C deficiency. Some children did this survey. Here are some of their reports. Group 1. We found something green around the taps in our school which is called algae. Due to algae, a kind of plant, it also had become slippery there. The algae spreads a lot during the rainy season. We think that they are some kind of small plants that grow in water. Can you see algae in or around the water? Where else have you seen algae? Yes, we can see algae in or around water. We can see algae in well, around water pipes, damp walls, pond, damp floor. This is the survey report of group 2. There is a pond near the school. At first, you cannot see the water in the pond as it is completely covered with plants. One auntie told us that these plants have grown themselves in water. Around the pond, there are pits full of water. We also saw some larvae in the water. As we moved around, lots of mosquitoes flew from the plants growing around. Jaskirat feels that there are so many mosquitoes in her house because of this dirty pond nearby. Children reported that water in the pond cannot be seen. It is completely covered with plants. This is the plant which generally covers the ponds. It is very common and you also must have seen these. It is water hyacinth. The fiber from the stems of the water hyacinth plant are left to dry for several days and are used to make ropes, bags and other craft items. Are there plants growing on the side or in water? Find out their names. Draw some of these in your notebook. Yes, there are many types of plants growing on the side or in water. Some of these are liverwort, duckweed, cattail, water lily. Do you think these were planted by someone or did they grow on their own? These grow on their own. Some more plants growing in or around water are dollarweed, horsetail, water shield, hydrilla, water lettuce, parrot feather, coon tail, bladderwort. What else can you see in water? Make a list. We can see frog, tadpoles, snail, mosquito larvae, water strider, fish, etc. in water. Here are the meaningful and lovely posters made by the students of class 5. I am happy to include these in this video. Here we finish our chapter. In this chapter we have discussed and learnt a lot about mosquito spread diseases and in detail about malaria, its symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, prevention. Then about nutrients of food with special reference to minerals, anemia, its symptoms, diagnosis, treatment and prevention. Reading a pathology report. To know and appreciate the contribution of scientists with special reference to Ronald Ross, fly spread diseases, algae and water weeds, other things in water, cleanliness important for health, and you have done a project also, making a poster to create awareness about malaria. Worksheets are given at the end. If you have any doubts, feel free to ask me in the comment section. I'll reply as soon as possible. See you soon in next chapter. Keep watching and stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Do like and subscribe my channel. Yes, we can. Learning, opportunity in crisis. For more upcoming videos.